Mothers Against Frisbees?
I have no idea.
Mothers Against Freaks.
It's M-A or M-O?
A group, maybe?
Mothers Against Frisbees?
No, what's it about?
My Aunt Frances.
Yes.
Men after females.
What?
Who's it getting fun?
What?
Mothers Against Frisbees?
The major reason we chose MAF is because we like the initials. It stands for Mothers Against Frisbees.
We want to stomp out all Frisbees. Actually, we didn't pick MAF. They selected us. And the large question that I have in my mind is, why did they select DeGarmo and Key to be their representatives? Their explanation is because they want to make young people aware of the missionary activity that's going on across the world and the network, what would you call MAF?
A ministry network?
A ministry, there you go, Eddie. It's a ministry network that allows missionaries to stay out in the field or in the jungle or in the bush.
You're in the trees.
A good friend of ours from California handed us a brochure a couple years ago that explained who MAF is and what they do. And we really had no idea how much an organization like that was needed until after we went to Africa and saw what they did and saw that without those airplanes, ministry work as we know it would cease. A lot of those people go home.
One of the important messages that DeGarmo and Key has always had is that faith must be backed up with action. And supporting MAF gives kids an opportunity to put their faith in action. That's why we're proud to make young Christians aware of the MAF needs and to challenge them to actually participate in a missionary's life through MAF. It's faith in action.
Last summer we had the opportunity to make quite a trip. We went to Zaire, Africa, with an organization called MAF, and no, that's not Mothers Against Frisbees. That's Mission Aviation Fellowship. And I know a lot of you guys don't know who they are or what they do, but they have a program called Air Care. They have about 150 airplanes throughout the world, and they fly missionaries and Bibles, medical supplies, and whatever is needed to remote regions of the earth. DeGarmo and Key was really taken back with the commitment of the pilots of MAF and the organization. And we need to pray for them and support them. What we need is a whole lot more of what we and DeGarmo and Key call the Holy Vessel.
It's faith in action.
With the tide, who's gonna see? It's Mission Aviation Fellowship.
Mission Aviation Fellowship.
They go in the jungle with the planes where the cars and trucks cannot go.
That's what I want to do. I want to be a mission aviator. I've had a desire to fly all my life.
We're going to pull together. We're going to support them.
I want to fly for the Lord.
Told me that Zaire was in the Belgian Congo, all I could think of were the Tarzan movies, because that was supposedly the setting of where Tarzan was from. And I kept, you know, in my mind, I conjured up pictures of natives and elephants, and actually going to Kinshasa and being in the inner city was a true heartbreak.
We see poverty in our nation and we see destitute people. But until you land in a city of 3.5 million people and you realize that 2 million of them have no place to sleep and they have no plumbing, and many of them, obviously there's no jobs. I mean, where do you work? There's no place to work. You don't understand what real poverty and real problems are. When one of the people went in the hospital, the whole family would travel with them and take care of them. I remember outside of the hospital rooms, there were like these big barbecue pits. I mean, that's what they were, I guess.
Kind of looked like Woodstock, didn't it?
Yeah, it kind of did. And all the women had turbans on, you know, and a couple things on their head walking around. And
Volkswagens.
A couple of Volkswagens on their head. We even heard one horror story about a mother breaking one of their child's arms so that they could go into the hospital so they could eat.
I asked my host why they spent so much time with agricultural projects and medical projects. And he said, well, you've got to understand this about these people. It's hard for them to hear the gospel when they're hungry. The missionaries were real excited about their agricultural project, you know. You know, we're teaching them how to grow potatoes over here and corn over there. And over here, we're teaching them how to, I don't guess you grow chickens, but whatever you do with chickens, they were doing it.
Make them.
Yeah, you make them. That's right. They were teaching them how to make chickens. And they were real excited about it. And I thought, well, you know, big deal. But then when I found out that the people primarily were hunters and they had hunted all the animals to extinction, and I kept asking, well, where are all the lions and tigers and elephants and all of that? And where they were is they'd all been eaten.
We visited two hospitals. We visited the hospital at Kempesi and the hospital, it was in Bonga.
At one of the hospitals that Ed mentioned, I met a surgeon there. His name was Dr. Russell, and he was British. And Dr. Russell did work at the leprosarium. And he explained to us, you know, all about leprosy and how they had finally figured out how to treat leprosy. And they medically, they can treat leprosy right there where you live. And so the natives who come down with leprosy, they can stay with their families now. But Dr. Russell, what he has to do is he has to go out once a month to that person and make sure that they take their medicine. And there's no way that Dr. Russell could do that without Mission Aviation Fellowship. His work would, you know, pretty much have to be at the hospital only.
He said he'd have to go home.
Yeah.
I mean, I asked him, I said, what would you do if MAF wasn't here? He said, oh, well, I'd have to go home. I want kids to get excited about what air care is all about. And in fact, we've met some of the pilots since we've been back that just, we thought they were insane because they were back over in the United States and all they could talk about was going back to Zaire. You know, and it was kind of like going back to the war zone.
One of the really exciting things about MAF to me was what a unifier MAF is among Christians. You know, when we're putting on concerts here in America, we've encountered in the last 10 years a lot of denominational lines and struggles. And that wasn't the case in Zaire. There was a network of different denominations out in the jungle reaching people for Christ. And MAF was like a lifeline that unified all these denominations. And so there really weren't Southern Baptists and Presbyterians over there. There were just Christian brothers and sisters trying to do the work of Christ. And I thought that was really wonderful. One particular missionary that we met over there, he was an older fella. He was in his 60s. This man had been there, I think, since he was about 21 or 22 years old. And he was talking about the vast improvements that they had made in his lifetime in there. And what I saw was a little block building that was a hospital. You know, and a few huts, and a little bit of cleared away jungle, you see. And I saw a bunch of kids singing, playing these little strange instruments I'd never seen before, having a great time. They had a church there, and he was talking about building that church with his bare hands. And I thought about 35 years of sacrifice. Honestly, this man had been there his whole life, and he'd been serving those people. And he had given up everything to help a few. When I got to Zaire, what I met were a lot of really sharp, intelligent, skilled people. Surgeons with tremendous ability, pilots that were skilled and talented, and computer operators and communications experts. And there they were, serving natives. When you don't care anymore about your reputation, when you let go of your dreams and you finally acknowledge in reality Jesus Christ is your God and He's the master of your destiny, that's when you've taken the first step out of being a casual Christian.
All right, this is it. I promise. This is the last time. This is. That last one was incredible. You ready to do another one? All right. Here we go. We're rolling.
I'm not afraid to die.
One of the other things that amazes me now and it amazed me then was how happy the missionaries were.
We saw hospitals being built.
They loved Zaire.
We saw churches being built.
And they loved the people of Zaire.
We saw people being fed.
I think that what I saw in the missionaries and the pilots there in Zaire was a deep sense of fulfillment and peace.
We saw some heroes. We saw some real Christian heroes.
For us, every moment is a praise rock song. And it's an effort for us to say, thank you, God, for the good things in our lives. And I'll tell you, when we were in Zaire, it constantly brought things to mind that I was thankful for. Somehow, every moment has become associated with airplanes. And I think that that's really...
It has to do with the video.
Yeah, well, of course it does. It has to do with the video. And that's great, because MAF doesn't have a person's face that they can plaster in front of you. They have to make you realize that what you're doing is paying the bills of keeping Bibles, supplies, and doctors and missionaries out in the field, and that involves airplanes. So every moment is raising the consciousness of MAF.
not everybody's called to go out and serve in the middle of the jungle. You know, we have a country over here, and we have needs over here too, but we can be a part of what those people do, and Air Care is a way to do that.
Eddie and I have never tried to raise money for any project like this before because we felt really uncomfortable. But this is a project that we really believe in, and we want you to understand that absolutely zero of the money goes to DeGarmo and Key. 100% of the money that you will send goes to the Mission Aviation Fellowship. And there's several ways that you can help MAF. You can contact MAF and they'll send you an air care kit. And in that kit, there'll be a lot of information, things perhaps that we didn't make clear or we left out. You can be a co-pilot. And being a co-pilot doesn't necessarily mean they'll come back, pick you up and you get to ride around an airplane. It means that you are sponsoring a pilot and his work in a certain country. You can adopt a plane. This is where they actually bring a plane to your house and you can keep it in your bedroom. No, that's not true at all. Adopt a plane is that you sponsor financially a different mission, a plane. The fourth thing, and this will take a lot of consideration on your part and a call from God perhaps, and that is to be a pilot yourself for Mission Aviation Fellowship. And it will require a lot of dedication on your part, but it certainly is a fulfilling way to serve Jesus Christ.
If you want to find out more about what we're talking about and what MAF does, and you need to find out because they do some great things, write a letter to them, MAF, Box 3202 DK, Redlands, California, 92373. Write them a letter and they'll send you some stuff and you can know more firsthand how you can help them and help them win this world for Jesus Christ.
Have you got that memorized yet, Eddie?
I've got it memorized and I write them every day.
You're fired.
No!
Go ahead, I'm sorry. I'm serious now.
I'm sorry.
I'm losing. I can run away.
Yeah, I'm kind of losing it here.
Ha, 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 ha,